In my previous video on the Raspberry Pi, I showed you how to install NOOBS. In this one, I'm going to show you how to install the Rasbian Stretch desktop, which I think is a lot easier. I'm Tom Kovichak, and this is Tom's Trains and Things. This channel was created to help other modelers who are in need of guidance in pursuing their dream of building a model railroad. And to automate our railroad, we are using Raspberry Pi and DCC++. And I showed you how to install the NOOBS software on it. Once you put the SD card in the Raspberry Pi, it does all the configuration from there. But I'm going to show you how to do the configuration with the Rasbian Stretch desktop. So all we have to do is burn the image to the SD card, put it in, and it's done. All you have to do after that is just answer a few questions like what country you're in, what language, and what keyboard, and what time zone, and you're done. And you could set a password if you want to also. So let's get going with this demonstration right now. Now we have to download the zip file from the Raspberry Pi website. From the Raspbian Pi website, we're going to go down to Downloads, and we're going to install the Rasbian operating system. We're going to bypass the NOOBS because I already showed you how to do that one. Okay, now we have some choices here. We have the desktop and recommended software, we have it without the recommended software, and we have the light. We're going to do the whole thing with the recommended software just in case you want to do some other tasks on there. Like it has like an office program on there, it has a couple of games on there, and you could do a lot of different things with it just in case. We're just going to do that one right here. So we're going to download the zip file to our data. Okay, and it's 1.8 gigabytes, so it's going to take a little while to do it. While we're waiting for the file to download on our computer, we're going to format our SD card. Now I'm using Windows, and I'm just going to use the Windows formatter on here. So we have our SD card right there. I think I already put something on this SD card, so what we're going to do is we're just going to format that and erase what's on it. So we'll come down to here where it says format. We're going to do FAT32, which is the default, and we're going to start it. Gives you the warning. Format complete, and we're done. So let's see how far we are. This is going to take a while. It says 12 more minutes left. If you don't want to use the Windows version to format a disk, or if you have a Mac, you can go over to the installation guide right here, and it'll give you some links to 7-zip for Windows, the Unarchiver for Mac, and Unzip for Linux. You could download those programs there for your operating system so you could format your SD card. Now, while we're at it, we're going to install Etcher over here. I'm going to download for Windows X64. And now it's going to download that along with the Raspberry Pi. So now it appears the Etcher is already finished, so we'll just open that up. And we'll show you what that looks like. You have to agree installing. Let's minimize that while that's happening there. All right, now we have Etcher on there. Okay, this is a little bit different than the icon on here is a little bit different than the one I have on my other computer. So let's open this up here. Okay, it's open now, and all we're going to do is wait on the download because it's still downloading the Rasbian file right here. It says it's got 5 minutes left, so we'll just wait on that. Now we finally finished downloading the file, so what we can do is we select the image. So click on there. We have it in progress data. It's this one right here, Rasbian Stretch Full Zip. And we open it. And a good thing about this is you don't have to unzip it. It'll take care of that. Now we select the drive. Okay, we got the SD card in H. So we select that one, click continue, and flash. Make sure 15.8 gigabytes, so I got the 16 gigabyte SD card in there, and we flash. Okay, SD card starting. All right, now this should take a few minutes, and once it's done, we have a bootable drive. Now, how quickly this takes to flash depends entirely on your processor on your computer. Now, the computer that I have right now is about 8 years old. It's on its last leg, and it's going to take a while. You can see it's at 54%. I've been doing this for about 5 minutes now. Okay, on my other computer that I just bought in January of this year, it flashed it in about, I'd say about 3 minutes, and it downloaded the file in 2 minutes. So it's a lot faster. So how long it takes depends on the speed of your computer. Now it's finished, so we could pull this thing out and install it in our Raspberry Pi. So altogether it took 15 minutes to burn the image on to this SD card. So now all we have to do is put this in the Raspberry Pi and it's ready to go. It already has the operating system on there. It'll boot right up. All you have to do is set up your country, your language, and your time zone, and you're good to go. And then whatever other configuration you want to do to the Raspberry Pi. Let's see what happens when I turn this on. There's the raspberries. Rebooting in 5 seconds. There we go. There's the welcome screen. Okay. Now we got to set this up again. United States, American English, and we look for New York. New York right there. Use US keyboard. Boom. And this is the same thing we had to go through with the noobs to set everything up. I'm not going to put a password on this. It's searching for networks. Click next. Even though this is a new system, we just uploaded it. It goes through the updates and it's up to date now. Okay, we'll reboot. Okay, we're ready to go. Let's make sure we have our Wi-Fi right here. Train of thought, that's good.
That's all there is to it. Now you know two different ways to install the operating system on your Raspberry Pi. And in my Q&As, I'll show you a third method. I was surprised by the comments that I received from the first one, and you'll be surprised too of how easy it is to set up not just DCC++, but any DCC system that you have, and I'll reveal that in the Q&A coming up in a few days. So until the next time, we'll see you.